Hello friends and welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we are going to learn how to create unmatch and duplicate queries in Microsoft Access 2016. Now as I move on with my next slide, it says that it is a very helpful wizard to basically find the unmatch queries and the duplicate queries. Now as the name suggests itself, the first one, that is unmatch queries, it will help me to find the unrelated records between two tables. And what is the duplicate query? As the name suggests itself, that it will help me to find out the duplicate records in a particular table or in two different tables. In my next slide, as you can see, that it is showing me how you perform this activity. So you basically go under the create tab, and under the create tab you will go to the queries group. Under queries group you will find a query wizard. The moment you click on a query wizard, a new pop-up window will come in which you have four options, out of which the two options will be find unmatched queries and find duplicate queries. Now the process for both the queries will be the same. It will basically ask you a series of questions like which table you want to refer, which are the field lists that you want to include, and after if you hit the finish button, it will give you your desired result. We will have a better understanding about how to create this unmatch and duplicate queries in our practical approach.
In this video, we are going to learn how to create unmatch and duplicate queries in Microsoft Access 2016. So let's go and perform these tasks. Now in order to perform these tasks, I'm using the same database that we have been using in our previous videos. Alright, so let me tell you what we are trying to do out here. So I have this customer database, as you can see. Now I have another table which says customer 2017. So what I've done out here, I want to be in touch, and I have kept a record of each and every customers, and I've kept a follow up of each and every customer. But out here, if you can see, there are just 163 records, but in our main database I have 200 records. So basically there are some 37 records which are missing out here. So I want to pull out those records which I haven't followed up yet. So in order to perform this task, I need to go to the query wizards. So basically I will move to the create tab, and under the create tab I will move to the query wizards. The moment I click on query wizard, it is basically asking me what query you would like to solve. So I say I want to find the unmatched record, so I'll say find unmatched query wizard. I'll simply hit on OK. Now the moment I hit on OK, it is basically asking me the very first question, which table contains or query contains a record you want in the query results. So I will select the parent database, that is my table customers, right? I simply hit on the next button. Now the next question it is asking you, find a table or query which contain the related records. So the related records are stored in my customer 2017 table. So I will select this table, and it will compare these two tables and give me the records which are not present in customer 2017. Alright, so I have given it as customer 2017. I move on to the next tab. I say next tab. Now it is asking me what you want to, what do you say, what piece of information is common in both the slides. I say the first name and the first name. I like to compare these two things, and please give me the results accordingly. So I say first name and first name, and it is comparing these two criterias from both the tables, and I simply hit on the next button. Now it is asking me what are the fields which you required in the result, what are the fields that I will be requiring in the results. So I say please mention the ID, the first name, the last name, and I would like to know the city of that customer as well, so that I can keep a follow-up. All right, I simply hit on the next button. Now the last thing it is asking me, what you want to name this. I say customers without matching customer 2017. So I say unmatching customer, so that will create a good name for the name for the event. So I say unmatching customers, what are the list name of the unmatching customers, right? So I've given it the name as unmatching customer 2017. I simply select the finish button, and it will automatically give me the records which are not common in both. The moment I click on this, it is giving me all the 37 records which I can see out here. These are the records which I have not followed up. So in this way I can create an unmatched query with the help of this query wizard, and it will sort out the, or it will filter out the records which are not common in all both these tables. So this was about unmatched queries. Now we'll move on and see how the duplicate queries are being sorted out. So basically I will again move to this this table which says customer 2017. Now out here in this particular record, you can see there are few records which have been repeated, right? I do not want to see the repeated records. I do not want the duplicate records to be out here. I just want the records to be perfectly and unique records. So I will again go to the Query Wizard tab, and under the Query Wizard tab, instead of finding unmatched query, I'll say find duplicates. All right. So I'll simply hit on OK. So basically it's asking which table or category. I say which table or query. I say I want to know it for customer 2017. I simply hit on the next button. So what the next question it is asking me, which field might contain the duplicate information. As you can see, as the ID are unique, the first name is being duplicated, so I use the first name as my criteria. So first name, it will search for the first name and give me the result accordingly. I'll simply hit on the next button. So the last thing it is asking me, what are the things do you want the query to show the field addition to the duplicate values? Yes, I want to know their ID, the last name, and again the city out here, right? And I simply hit next. And the last question it is asking me, what should be the name of the query? So duplicates, I will name this as duplicates of 2017. All right, so I'll simply hit on finish. The moment I click on finish, you can see all the duplicate data which is mentioned out here. So these are my duplicate records, which I do not want the repetition of these records, and I would like not to repeat this record. So this particular query is giving me all the duplicates record that we have in this particular table, that is customer 2017. All right, so this was all about this video where we learned how to create unmatched and duplicate queries.